What's up, guys? We have a game with the black pieces against the needs, 881. He opens up with a4. We're just going to take control of the center while he does this weird stuff on the side. He develops his bishop. This threatens our pawn. We're going to defend with a developing move towards the center. And now he keeps making flank pawn moves. Not scary at all. I'm going to take more of the center with the F pawn. It does open up this diagonal, but he's not developed, so it doesn't matter. Now he's doing more stuff like this. It's more ridiculous stuff. So we're just gonna develop towards the center. Our position looks great. We can castle. We can develop. We can even take more of the center with 4 pawns. That's a lot of pawns. You know, it's more responsibility. So you have to be careful when you do that. So I'm going to keep it simple and just castle. He brings his knight to the side. It's not the most effective square ever. I'm just going to bring out another piece, and now I have 3 pieces out. I'm castled. I have a pretty center. And, you know, black has to be doing better here. White moves the same piece twice. This doesn't come with any threat. At any point, I can kick it, but there's no point in kicking it now. That creates weaknesses. So unless you're going to trap it, you don't really want to kick it for no reason. There are so many pawn pushes. I really like I'm looking at this one, right? To open up my bishop, to open up my rook, and to just use this as a hook and open up his king. So if I go here, he can't push past. If I go here and he takes and I take, I mean, it opens up his bishop, but so what? I mean, if here, 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 and he takes this, and I take it to queen, and he gives me this check, and I just move my king, his rook is hanging there. Also, checkmate. So, like, you could develop the bishop, but it doesn't really do anything. So, like, you should try to, I guess, get your rooks in the game and your bishop, and there's really no way to do that. I mean, you could, you know, support the bishop here, but I feel like it's just, what are you really doing? I feel like at least this makes more sense. You can at least develop the bishop this way if you want. It also develops the rook. And it's really targeting a weak point. Because once you're here, you already have you already did center, right? And development. You could continue development, you know, and really just do everything, but I'm going to try to keep the initiative, and I'm going to push and try to open up his king, because his king is weak. So he retreats the knight on purpose, so he moved it from here to here to here to here, which is kind of funny. This double hits the pawn, but the pawn is defended. And now we can open up this dark square stuff. We can hit his knight and then come in with the bishop check. His king has to move. Now the rook is staring at the king. This has to all be very bad for him. But maybe we can start even with pushing this, and if he moves the knight somewhere, then we can take. He can't take back because that would be checkmate. I guess we could start with kicking the knight center. We're going to use the center now that we're dominating it. And my opponent left the game. Awesome. He's back. So also, if he moves here, is this ever a thing? Takes. I mean, it's unnecessary. We can just take here. Now we're threatening to take with check. Of course, if he takes here, we take back with check, and we also have this. If our knight wasn't here, that would be mate. So, do we throw in this? Do we throw in knight g4? That way he can't move his king. I guess he could like go this way then, check, and he could run this way. That's still terrible. I guess you could close the door with e3 if he tries that. If he pushes this pawn... I guess it... I don't know. It all looks so bad. If I take here first, he's forced to go here. Then I go here with check. That looks terrible for him too. It all looks terrible. Alright, we'll just take with check. We have the queen also coming in one of these squares. The bishop or the knight coming in there. He moves the king, so we have a discovered check. This maybe, or this. I'm going to go just with this one. Coordinates here 3 times. So that's a real pain for him. And he moves his king. But now I have this check, which wins this knight. Also, this check, he's forced to go back. Do I have a checkmate there? I mean, I could take the knight with check. And then if his king goes here... I mean, I could keep winning a bunch of stuff. I could win the bishop then. So let's just do that. I don't want to calculate any further. This is clearly winning if I win 2 pieces like that. And now we take this with check. Of course, you could win material this way, right? Now if we take this rook, we're covering this... I mean, take this, we're covering this square. So that lets us go here, and his queen is trapped, whereas before it wasn't trapped. So even if you sack your bishop, his queen is dead. Also, you can probably go for checkmate if he brings his rook over. Let's just win the queen. He might resign. It's a pretty sweet concept. Just utilizing this as an escape square. A lot of you, as soon as the bishop's attacked, you're automatically dropping it back somewhere. You really want to get rid of the automatic habits of reactiveness, of automatically reacting to your opponent's moves. So he takes the bishop, we take the queen, and now let's just get our queen in the game somehow. Well, first let's develop our bishop and eye this so he can't develop it. Also, if we put our queen here, he was going to exactly do this. And then we would have to move our queen again. You could win the rook there, but at least in this case, now when we go here, we're hitting the double. So I was just waiting for this. And if you look at the central squares, does he have anything there? No. But look at our control over the center. Right? Undeniable. King safety. Look at his king. Look at ours. He never got to castle. He blocks this, but what's the drawback of this move, guys? What's the drawback of the move, guys? Checkmate is the drawback of the move. So let's go through it. Your opponent plays ridiculous stuff. He deserves to get punished. You should be the one. Center. One of these two moves. In this position, you need to make one of these two pawn moves, right? Don't make other moves. Very simple. One of these pawn moves. Okay. Your next move should be d5. You shouldn't be making other moves, right? Of course you can. Of course other moves are playable and fine, but this is... How could you get more logical than this? If you're explaining your moves, this has to be the best. Okay, so center, we did center and development. Now we have development and center. Now we have more center, and it also helps development. We have more development and center. We have king safety and development. Now we have more development and center. And now we have an attack on the king. This pawn move, it's development, yes. It definitely helps your development. The idea is definitely to play with this open F file, you know, which we did, and we had clear benefits. But it's also to open up his king safety, because he doesn't really have time to castle now, because you're going to take in his pawn. It's so weak, and he can't go the other way because he didn't even start moving that stuff. And so this is being open whether he likes it or not. My rook is going to be have amazing development. So this move is about development. And I already have the center, right? Like, what else is there when I say center? You know, like, just throwing a knight in here is not going to do anything. Because whenever you go to your opponent's camp, you have to have coordination squares. I don't coordinate with anything. So it's better to control the center. So when I say center, like, I already got the center. He didn't even contest it. So I already achieved my goal. I have the best center you could ask for. And now his king is weak, so we're going to use our development to attack his king. And then here, center again with threats to open up his king. And then we already have the center controlled. Look at these four squares. This knight's not actually good. This trade is good for us. It supports the center, so this knight only blocks his bishop. So good for us. And now we just crash through. It's completely winning, completely crushing, because our amazing development, right, combined with the fact his king can't move. Terrible king safety, terrible bishop. This knight's not developed. This queen is stuck, whereas our queen gets in the game. His bishop is being blocked by his own knight. No pawns in the center, but he made these two pawn moves, a4 and h4. I mean, come on. These moves are terrible. And I know a lot of you guys also make those moves. But you can see how they actually don't do anything. They completely gave me the center. And now you can see white being destroyed. He wanted this double fianchetto, but if you double fianchetto but don't take the center, you're just going to get overrun. So anyway, it's just game over. There's nothing he can do here. It's just all these moves are so weakening. This pawn that he pushed would love to go back and defend this pawn. That's why you don't just push pawns for no reason like that. So it comes with check. And then these are just tactics, you know, winning tactics, winning a piece, a queen. And so we did center, development, king safety. And then once everything is in place, especially if your opponent's king's not safe, you just attack it. If it is safe, then you can continue the build-up of development, you know, whatever you need. So, hopefully that helps some show you how to beat these guys who do ridiculous rook pawn moves, right? You take control of the center, develop your pieces. Alright, submit your rapid games in my Discord. Good luck in your chess games. Goodbye.